TV is something millions of people around the world are blessed with every day. But for many others, it doesn't happen naturally. Many turn to in vitro fertilization, which can be very expensive. Jessica Miles has more now on a new online test that can give hopeful parents some helpful information.
For years, 33-year-old Gretchen Barrett and her husband tried to have a baby.
I'm trying to conceive for 2 years unsuccessfully, seeing a lot of doctors, not finding any answers to what our fertility problems were.
After 6 rounds of failed artificial insemination, they turned to in vitro fertilization, an expensive decision.
Costs can range from $17,000 to $30,000, depending on the clinic that you use, the medication that you have, and if you have any coverage with your health insurance.
But it's one they wouldn't change for the world. Little Eva Elizabeth will be one in 2 weeks.
I think it's great.
In the past, fertility experts primarily used a woman's age to determine if IVF would work. But now a new online test will give couples a personalized prognosis. Unified prediction tests take into account not only a woman's age, but their body mass index, hormonal levels, previous pregnancies or miscarriages. It also takes into account the male partner's data, like age, sperm count, and any known infertility issues. All of these factors are analyzed and together give a percentage, the likelihood in vitro fertilization will be successful.
When I read about it, it was definitely something that I would have done if it was available.
There are 2 tests, one for women considering IVF for the first time, the other for those women considering a repeat IVF treatment, whether it worked the first time around or not. The tests range in price from about $50 up to $350.
It's very cost effective, especially knowing you're going to do IVF and you're going to be spending tens of thousands of dollars.
Jessica Miles, 5 Eyewitness News.
There is a new piece of technology that is helping couples increase their odds of having a baby, even with fertility treatments. Researchers conducted a small study in England using simple photography to choose the healthiest embryos created by in vitro fertilization. Now, a camera inside each special incubator captures embryo development every 15 seconds. Embryos change constantly, and researchers were better able to pick the best embryo for pregnancy. The success rate for women under 35 went from 42% to 61%. They now hope to replicate those results on a larger scale. Many couples, though, of course, struggle with infertility, too many. And according to the CDC, it's about 6% of married women in the U.S. between the ages of 15 and 45 who can't get pregnant. And about 11% of women in that same group have trouble getting pregnant. About 7.5% of men under 45 reported seeing a fertility doctor in their lifetime. Overall, the CDC says that fertility treatment success rates are about 40% in women under 35 and drop several percentage points every few years. The success rate drops to just 1% for women who are older than 44. And if you'd like more information on this new IVF test, you can head to the links page at KSTP.com.
Topping health headlines tonight, the Food and Drug Administration says menthol cigarettes are a bigger public health risk than regular cigarettes. The FDA says there is not evidence that